You know, we often make jokes about mansplaining, but the truth is it can leave us frustrated, hurt, and feeling lesser than. So here to help us challenge it the next time it happens and get us prepared is communication and body language expert Karen Donaldson, who I finally get to meet in real life. Karen, welcome. And first, let's start by just giving a, could you give us a clear description of what mansplaining is?
Absolutely. The technical definition is when a man overly simplifies something when he's speaking to a woman. Mm. And usually a way that's demeaning or patronizing, or he waits until she finishes and then he re-explains it because he feels like he's more knowledgeable on the topic. Yeah. We've often all experienced it, but we often also dismiss it.
Now, I know the second one more. So it's like, oh, I just said that, and then a man will say it, and it's like, everybody's like, yeah, what he said. And it's like, no, but I just said that. So often when this occurs, like, we're not necessarily prepared to handle it. We're sort of wrong-footed. You don't know what to do.
It's so true. I mean, a lot of women aren't used to really calling it out because we're not prepared. And the key thing is this, or the reality is this. We have been socialized as women to be polite, show a lot of appreciation, and be patient. And it starts from a really young age. So, I mean, if you look at kids in the playground, at school, or just amongst each other, it's okay for boys to rough play and rough house, but girls have to be polite. And if they do rough house, they're being called, you know, separate, calm down. So it starts there. And I mean, as a senior executive communication coach, I'm always having, or often having, to call up men in their tracks and let them know that, you know what, I've got it. I'm fully equipped, and I'll take it from here.
How do you do that? Like, what exactly do you? Do you call them in? Do you call them out? Do you keep, like, do you get savage? Do you, are you polite? How do you do it?
There's, you know, here's the first thing. Before we even get to what to say, you have to look at and talk about your level of confidence, because that's exactly what stops us from speaking up. So when we talk about your level of confidence, you want to really realize that you have to shift things for things to change.
Right.
And you have to know that confidence is not an emotion, so stop waiting to feel confident to speak up. It's a skill set, and it's an action, which means you can actually choose to do it. Like, that's one thing.
Okay.
Right? The other thing when it comes to confidence is you really have to be intentional with the conversation you have with yourself in your own head. So instead of sitting and saying, oh my God, this is crappy, I want to speak up, no, they're going to laugh, you have to separate that and say, you know what, I'm going to speak up. No one knows what you think unless you actually say it. And the third thing that you want to really keep in mind outside of the first two is that you have to be intentional, right? You get to choose. And I want you to commit to the act of speaking up because your voice matters. And stop committing and focusing on what the other person or what the men in the room will say or how they'll react. We have zero control over it. So let's take control over us and speak up.
So this is almost like the sort of process that needs to start when you're, like, just at home by yourself. Like, you have to start saying to yourself, no, 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 when if I feel a way, if there's something I need to say, if someone is speaking over me, if someone is mansplaining, I am going to be intentional, I am going to speak up, so you can hype yourself up so that when you get in that situation, you can do it, right?
Definitely. You want to have some pre-prepared statements. And, I mean, it comes to body language, so verbal communication and nonverbal communication. But here's where it starts. If we look at the nonverbal communication, if you're in a space with someone who's mansplaining you or who's man interrupted you, you physically want to look them eye to eye to show the seriousness of it. And then you also want to turn your body, your upper body, so you're squarely facing them. So, so it goes back to, if we look at just human psychology, when our parents speak to us, do you remember that look?
Yes.
Tracy?
That's all I needed.
That's it.
Like, don't even say my name. It's so, like, just the look.
You got it. So it's literally implied. So that's the one piece. Eye contact, square your body off. Now, you have to have pre-prepared phrases, and these are some phrases that people can practice. Okay. So it sounds something like this. Tom, you want to say their name as well when you square up. You want to pause and say, Tom, I've got this. I'll take it from here.
Okay.
Pause again and then continue saying what you're saying. That's one way.
Okay.
Another one, because you asked, how do you say it, your tone, and it totally depends on the relationship with the person. Because sometimes you can say this, Sam, you're mansplaining me. Right? So it depends on
the relationship. If you have that relationship, go for it, right?
It's all about the relationships, and that will, you know, really influence the tone of it as well. And another one is, you know what, I'm here for a reason. If I need to share some information about my background, I'll do so, but I've got this. And the tone doesn't have to be like that. It can be like, you know what, I have this. If you have any questions, could you just please keep it until the end, and I'll answer anything you have.
Oh, I like that one, too.
We have to confront it, Tracy. We really have to confront it.
And you don't agree with the whole, let me just take Tom aside afterwards and say something, like, say to him, listen, Tom, that, you know, it was a little out of pocket. I had it, and you jumped in there. You say, no, say it at the meeting. Like, speak up.
Right. I definitely say speak up because when ladies come to me and they say, well, Karen, can I pull them aside? Mm. I'll say, because you're asking me that question, I know this has happened more than once.
Right.
So when are you going to stop showing up in that manner?
Yes.
Right. So we have to start doing so. And men won't do it to their fellow men. So let's call it out in the moment and be done with it. And they'll know how to act, or we'll let them know how we want them to respond to us when they're in the midst of mansplaining. And
right.
Just that we don't appreciate it.
Is there anything else we can do to support men to stop mansplaining?
Really good question. So the thing is this, to all the men watching, or for men in general, if you feel the need to mansplain, I want you to know that it's an act of dominance and it's being dismissive and it's not okay, because you would not do it to your fellow man. It's mm-hmm. just plain disrespectful. Mm-hmm. And here's a bigger piece. I call men and I encourage women to call men and call them out and ask them to check themselves and say, what is it saying about me? Am I feeling threatened as a man, or am I not confident? So putting it back on them, right? And then the other thing is this, gentlemen, if you are called out, just apologize.
Yeah.
But no undercutting, so do not do this. It looks like I hit a sensitive nerve, Tracy. It's just as bad as mansplaining.
Yes, don't say that.
Don't say that at all. And I mean, if, depending on the relationship with the woman, ask her what she would prefer instead. And ladies, this is our time to let them know what we would like instead of what they've just done. We do not want to leave it in their hands anymore, because we saw the mansplaining.
That's
so let
right.
them know. So you know what, Sam? In the future, if you have something to say, I'd appreciate that if you took me to the side after the meeting, and let's have a conversation then, instead of doing it in front of the whole group.
Really good, Karen. Great lesson. Let me just square my shoulders and look in the camera. That is so good, ladies. We got this. We can deal with this.